Hi, welcome to the middle school virtual tour. I'm Damon Brown. I'm the middle school director. And this is Jen Bistritz.
Hi.
She is the middle years program coordinator who handles our curriculum through grades 6 through 10. And then we also have with us Crysta Swarts.
Hello.
Who is our dean of students. And we're going to be giving you a sort of behind the scenes tour of middle school at Riverstone. So right now we are in my office, which interestingly kind of shows the whole history of our school, because on the wall you can see all our outdoor program stuff. You can see some student art on the other wall. And this is a place that students and teachers come to meet with me on a pretty regular basis. And then right next to my office, we have...
This is my office. So this is the Dean of Students office. And so similarly to Damon's office, this is a place where students and teachers and parents can come to meet with me to chat about things, both formally and informally. And also I have this window to the hallway. And so always sort of waving the kids, checking them in for temperature checks in the morning, whatever they need, they know they can kind of knock on my window and I can point them in the right direction.
Yes. And so what we're going to do now is we're going to move over to kind of the middle school front desk area and begin sort of our geographic tour from there and show you around campus, show you many of our middle school classrooms, and what some of your new middle school students can expect as they come to school here.
Thank you.
We're gonna go ahead and walk over to a different building and we're gonna say hi to Sydney.
So as we go, we'll try to say the things that would be useful for you, but if you have questions, you can either put them in the chat or just shout it out and we'll answer them. And we'll also make sure to ask about questions at the end. So just to give you a sense of like geography, right? So right over here across the parking lot is the elementary school. So on this side of campus, we have three main buildings, not including the gym. And we call them the North Fork, Middle Fork, and South Fork buildings. North closest to the mountains and is the one with the big mural on it, which you probably see when you come in the mornings and afternoons.
And then the Middle Fork building is right here. It's the all concrete structure. And then the South Fork building is the one we were just in, where Crysta and my office are, and we'll be going back into that building in a minute. But first, let's come in here and see Sydney. Oh, look, here's one of our art and design teachers, Tana. We're giving some new middle school students a virtual tour of our campus.
Excellent. This is awesome.
Yeah, I know.
Well, I hope y'all have fun on your tour. Enjoy.
Yeah. All right. So, if students have questions or need to find out something about their schedule or find out about any other kind of basic piece of information for their day, they can check in right here with Sydney. We're going to show you. This is Sydney. She's right here at the front desk of the middle school. And she's here. She answers my questions. She answers your questions. And she answers your students' questions. She knows a lot of things.
Yeah, this is also where you will pick up your student if they are leaving school early. So maybe they have a dentist appointment. And this is also where they come to sign out if they are leaving early.
We have a live student signing out.
Right? Oh, look.
Live example. Watch it happen in front of you. So if you need to pick up your student for an appointment or if they're coming late because something happened in the morning, they'll just come and check in right here or sign out here, and this is where you can pick them up as well.
Right. So also in the Middle Fork building are the middle school music classes. So I'll show you that room. So room 46. Is where middle school music takes place. Hello. And so you can see in, this is our one of our music rooms. This is the one where most of the middle school music courses happen. And Mr. Pacheco is not here today, but this is his room where he often teaches his classes.
Thanks.
And then we're gonna move over, since we did music, we'll move over to our art department, which is actually our middle school art classroom is in the North Fork building. So we're gonna go into this building over here.
This is very similar, almost exactly, to the tour that your students went on during class last week with members of the current sixth grade class who toured them around and showed them all the classrooms. And one of the questions that came up was like, how will I ever remember where all these rooms are and what my classes are? And the answer, first of all, is that like, it's fine, you don't have to remember. And second of all, you can always just ask.
And we have maps and schedules up all over the school to help you if you need help. So we're gonna walk. We have our wonderful otter mural here in the north. The North Fork building is sort of the mural building right now. I have murals everywhere with all kinds of fun things. Yep. And then also down here, we have the art room. And we're gonna just peek in to the middle school art room. Hello, everyone. Welcome. We're giving a virtual tour of the middle school buildings. And so we're coming and we're visiting the art classroom. And these are art students and they're in the middle of making alabrijes, I believe. Yeah, alabrijes. Excellent.
Doing a disciplinary unit with Hilda. It's more applicable in the first semester because she does the Day of the Dead, right?
Sure. Still.
Yes, they need to learn three-dimensional skills, right?
Yes,
even
sculpture.
I'm helping Dana with
me. We can't help you.
Thank you, artists.
Oh, thank you.
And then just across the hall here is our outdoor education office. And this is Derek Wright, our outdoor education or an experiential education coordinator.
Oh, nice,
we're giving these, this tour to and it's recorded for people who aren't here.
Oh, cool.
But it's a virtual tour for incoming middle school students. Mm-hmm. And so can you tell us a little bit about what sixth graders can expect in their outdoor program or outdoor experiences?
Sure. So sixth grade is starts off with a lot of, or during their welcome week when they come here, I do a lot of team building activities with the sixth graders, which kind of starts their community building here in the middle school. And then they go to Yellowstone for their fall trip. And then in the winter, they go back up to Bogus and do skiing and snowboard lessons. And they'll do that for seventh grade as well. They'll go four times. And then in the springtime, we'll do some other outdoor education stuff. But this is where they turn in all their forms. This is where they can come find out where to go hiking with their family and different stuff like that.
Cool. Thank you, Derek.
You're welcome.
Appreciate it.
See you.
We're going to walk down here to our Mandarin room, just because it's a fun room to look at, because it's decorated so nicely. And we're just going to come in. You can just walk in. Hello. We're just giving a virtual tour to some incoming middle school students.
Oh,
and
nice.
So we just thought we'd visit the Mandarin room.
Yes.
This is... Julie Lin, one of our Mandarin teachers, and this is the space where she and Hui, our other Mandarin teacher, where they prep for classes, and also sometimes we hold classes in this room, but we have lots of fun maps and decorations and things to help students track with their language study.
Yeah. And we have the bamboo brush thing down there on the shelf.
Oh, yes, for calligraphy.
And those like a Chinese yo-yo, stuff like that. Perfect. My advisee just play with them over here.
Wonderful.
Right.
Thank you.
What grade is this student going to be at?
This is a video that we're recording for all middle school students who are coming in. And this is an incoming sixth grader who's joining.
I see, yeah. Gotcha. Very nice. Have fun.
Thank you.
And then Most of the other classes that happen in this building are upper middle school and high school classes. So we're going to actually head down to back down to the South Fork building and walk into most of our middle school classes. Yeah. It was interesting because Julie just mentioned her advisees. And one of the programs we have to help students integrate, develop social relationships and connections with faculty members is the advisory program, which is run by Crysta.
That's right. So advisory, you'll hear me talk about it quite a bit. If you came to our coffee, our Across the Bridge coffee, where we talk about advisory. So this is mixed age groups. So sixth graders are in mixed age groups with seventh, eighth, and ninth graders. So they get a chance to interact with folks who aren't just in their grade. They have a faculty member who's their advisor and will be their advisor for those 4 years. Then they move up to the upper advisory, along with all the kids they used to be an advisory with who are older than them, and they'll get a new faculty advisor then. Advisory is a place where you get one-on-one connections with a teacher. You get a chance to get some reflection done. For instance, today students were preparing for their upcoming student-like conferences with their advisors, and we also play a lot of games. A lot of games. So this is the South Fork where we were before. Elementary school is right over here. And of course, like the library is right here. So if you've ever come and had your kid drop something off the library, it's just right here.
And right in through these doors is where you find my office and Krista's office. And then also on our right here is where Andrea's office is, whom you know is our school counselor. So if we walk down this way, we'll come first to one of our middle school science rooms here. This is quite a fun room to check out because Mr. Pedersen consistently has themed rooms. And so come check out, we're moving into sort of the Hobbit and the Lord of the Rings. So this is our middle school science room. Students in sixth grade learn earth and environmental science. And JP, who many of the students call Mr. Pedersen, has done a great job of using fiction and fantasy to help students learn about physical earth science and the environment.
That's right. So the classroom is themed, but JP also then makes all of the experiences to go along with the theme. So for instance, in sixth grade, as I bet if you ask your fifth grader, they'll tell you about learning from JP just a few days ago when they were over here about the quests that they will complete in sixth grade science, including building a catapult to see how many of your individual soldiers you can get over the battlements.
Yes, right. Very good. Let's move on. We'll have a look at our science lab next. This is one of our science labs. This is the one most commonly used by middle school students. You can go on in, Jen. And so this is a pretty typical science lab space. And students come in here as a place to do their individual labs, and also as they get older to do their independent labs. Students will sign up to use this space for their projects. Yeah, let's move on and visit math.
We also have student clubs on this side. And one of our current student clubs is an arts and crafts club, and they use the lab space for their club meetings because it's a nice place that you can get messy and clean up easily.
So now we're going to quietly peek into Jen Coffey's math classroom. This is one of our middle school math classrooms. So I'll give you a quick peek. Hi, we're just in the middle of a virtual tour, so if you guys just want to wave and say hi. This is a tour we're recording and also offering live for some incoming middle school students and their families. So,
There's a lot of new students.
And then this next room is typically where students will study Spanish. Right now they're studying English.
That is awesome.
Hello. We're giving a little virtual tour to some incoming families.
Oh, awesome.
And so you guys can give them a wave. These are actually some of the current sixth graders studying their English class with with our COVID protocols in place, we've been trying to minimize student movement around campus. So that's why some classes are not in their rooms that they typically are in.
You can see that the locker banks are here. Because of COVID, we're not using our lockers this year, but in design tech, the students created sort of paper lockers to show themselves and the kinds of things that they're interested in. But starting at the beginning of next year, if we're able to use our lockers safely, those will be assigned by Sydney Bergen at the front desk, and your student will have a locker where they can put their stuff during the day.
Next, we can come to one of our design and art rooms. Students take both design and art in grade six, and this room gives them the space to design and build fun things. And of course, here's Tanith preparing for her work. And so we love the fact that we have these spaces that give students room to spread out and do large-scale hands-on projects.
So the South Fork building is shaped like a U, so we're just going around the side to U. To give you some more context, the library is right up here on the right. And if you came out here, we would be at the back end of the Middle Fork building. So most middle school classes take place in this building.
Mm-hmm. And you were passing other similar classrooms with different classes going on. Right here is a English class in session. This is Ms. Schooler's English class. We're giving a little virtual tour.
You're watching
All right. So again, if you have any questions, please put them in the chat, or you can just ask them. Hello.
Give me a virtual tour.
We are. This is Mrs. Smutzler, one of our science teachers.
Hi.
And so we're recording this and also offering it live to some incoming middle school students.
Oh, awesome. Look forward to seeing you.
Yeah. All right. Well, let's walk down this way. We'll walk over toward the gym. While we're doing that, are there any questions of the people who are with us live right now? All right. Well, we'll go ahead and keep going then.
So you can see there are some elementary school students having recess. In sixth grade, we don't have recess anymore, but we do try to make sure that sixth graders are getting time to run around, to play, to just have some free open time for themselves in between classes, especially in the beginning as they're getting used to the slightly more rigorous academic workload. So we have two times in particular where you might see middle schoolers running around and having a good time. Lunch is one of those times, of course. And then every day we have a section of the day called community time, which includes balance and enrichment, which basically lets students decide for themselves, what do I need today? Maybe it's free time, maybe it's playing basketball with a friend, but maybe it's going to a club meeting, maybe it's having a meeting with a teacher. And so we have those times blocked out every day, especially so that our sixth grade students can get their energy out.
Yeah, for sure. And so our gym, obviously, students who have been at Riverstone for elementary school will be familiar with our gym space. We do our classes here and around it as well. We go in this way. Another thing that's important to note is we've been in blended learning due to COVID-19 protocols for this school year. But starting after spring break, we are going to be offering all students the opportunity to be on campus every day. We're going to be still following all of our health and safety protocols, including social distancing and mask wearing. That's why we're going to be bringing a number of very large tents to campus, some big structures that we can use, that we can have class in this spring, so that we can get everybody together again safely.
Oh,
And so you'll start seeing those tents popping up around campus soon as we get ready for that process.
So this is the entrance to our gym, of course, and it's, as you can see through the window, got some elementary school students in there doing PE, and looks like they're playing a pretty cool game. All right. Well, one more check for questions, and then we'll let you go for today. If you missed this video, we're glad that you can join it in recorded form. And if you have any questions, we look forward to hearing from you. We'll all be here, and we're excited for you to join us soon.
Thanks so much.